During this 1984 interview with one of our reporters, tax protester Carl Holacek gave his reasons why he wouldn't pay his taxes. Now he's so fed up with the government and its laws that he says he doesn't want to be a part of it anymore. He has seceded from the Union, just like the Confederacy did 125 years ago.
Holacek isn't the first person from this state to try to leave the Union. In fact, last year, 10 people did it. Here are their notices of secession and transference. These are letters that instruct the State Patrol that they no longer abide by the laws of the United States government. These letters are delivered here to State Patrol headquarters. And once they get here, they wind up on the desk of Colonel Elmer Komacher, who keeps them.
State Patrol Colonel Elmer Komacher says, legally speaking, the letters of secession aren't worth the paper they're written on, that people simply cannot secede from the Union. He says they haven't broken any law by doing it, but because of their political views, they are watched very closely by police.
When does a person's political philosophy, let's say, their way of thinking about politics, when does that become the business of the Nebraska State Patrol?
When it becomes a violation of the existing statutes or existing laws.
In 1983, North Dakota tax protester Gordon Call allegedly killed two lawmen in a gunfight here, another in a firefight at this mountain retreat in Arkansas before he was killed. Komacher's own men killed Carroll farmer Arthur Kirk. He had barricaded himself in his home with gun in hand, in part over political principles. Komacher says from now on, he'll keep track of Nebraska's right-wing secessionists.
I think everyone is entitled to their own thoughts. They have their own ideas, but that certainly does not give them the authority to take the law into their own hands.